Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So we are continuing our Autumn Fairy and Fairytopia by Mystic Art Mirrors. Again, I've printed it on tone tan paper and we are coloring this image. So to continue, I'm just going to go ahead and kick things off coloring the pine cones. And with the pine cones, I really don't want to make them brown. I like to make them like a burgundy or some type of dark red, and I've done it before and I really like the outcome, so I'm just going to go ahead and make these that color. But when I did them the first time, I did them in Holbeins, but we're using our Black Widows for this picture. I'm going to stick with them for the entirety of this picture because they don't get enough love, and like I said, I have all the sets and I haven't used them in a while, although I really like them. They're one of my favorite sets as a whole. And yeah, we're just going to continue with the pine cones. I hope you all have been enjoying this color along. And if you have the Black Widows, that you break yours out and you can use them. Or if you just learn some cool color combinations from this video, or whatever you take away from it, it's all cool. And I'm happy that you're watching, and I hope you're having fun coloring this picture because I had a lot of fun coloring it. I always have a lot of fun coloring a Mystic Art Mirrors, I think I've said before. And we're going to pretty much finish up the picture almost. There'll be one more part and then we'll be completely done. And yeah, it was quick and fun. And I hope you enjoy. Here, I'm breaking out my super tips and I'm using them on the leaves. Now, feel free to do your leaves whichever kind of green that you would like, but I do not like to color leaves or flowers or foliage or shrubbery or blooms or blossoms or anything of that matter. So if I can find a shortcut or cheat my way to getting all that type of stuff done, if I have it in my picture, I am the first one in line. I'm the first one on the train. So that's why I'm deciding to use my super tips, because they make short work of it, and it helps because it acts as a good base to have down, and I don't have to work as hard to put layers on top and get a nice opaque color.
Thank you.
So here I have decided to make a green lip. I don't know why, I really like to color green lips. I've done a couple and I don't know, I just really like to make girls have green lipstick or green lip gloss or whatever it is. I just like to color green lips. So I'm going to go ahead and make her lips green. So for her hair, I've decided to do kind of like an ombre hair. So it's going to be like a really dark pink into a light pink. And it kind of matches the pine cones, which I didn't really think about before, but It really does. That was not my intent. I think it looks cool either way though. So I'm going to take this super tip and baste the hair, and I'm just using super tips because it'll help expedite the process. It won't take me forever to get all my layers down. Super tips acts as a really good base and you don't have to work as hard. So it's just something really handy, and I think it's an essential thing to have if you're a colorist or you draw or do anything of that nature, because they're really fun. You get a lot of colors. I have the 100 set and they're very versatile. So I'm just basing her hair with the two different colors of super tips, and then it looks a little wonky at first because it does not blend very well, but when we come in with our pencils it will definitely start to look like something and it won't look so scary. Thank you. Why would my pencil decide to break like this, y'all? The shock. The shock. I just sharpened it using my M&R sharpener with the shorter end, and then all was saved. So I was okay after that technical difficulty.